This is scary.
Break it down.
I was working late on my half Torah when I heard a knock on my bedroom door. I opened it up, and to my surprise, there was a werewolf standing there with glowing gold eyes. He says, "Tomorrow, my son, you will be a man. But tonight's the time to join the Wolfen Clan."
Hello, whiteboard viewers. This is Rebecca giving you the Whiteboard Friday spiel. Rand is in Sweden visiting the Ace of Base Memorial Museum, so I'm in charge of Whiteboard Friday this week. So this week we're going to talk about some landing page tips. Jeff and I have been working with Carlos Del Rio, who took second place in our landing page contest, on kind of retooling some of our landing pages and adding existing landing pages for our premium content. So along the way I've learned some pretty neat stuff from Carlos about landing page tips, and I thought I'd run by a few pointers for you today. All right, first of all, what you want to do is you want to keep your landing page consistent with your ad. And I'm using a sexy Chinese finger trap as my pointer. Ooh. Anyway, so you have your AdWords ad here, and if it's going to talk about sexy blue widgets, what you're going to want to do is have your landing page pretty much have the same call to action that your ad displayed. You don't want to have sexy blue widgets to grab, you know, your searcher's attention and then have it be something about little ponies instead. They're not going to want to convert, they're just going to want to click away. So I recommend maybe having whatever your call to action was on your ad be your title on your landing page. Secondly, what you want to do is place any testimonials you can get next to the corresponding action. Earlier we surveyed some of our premium members and asked them what they thought of our premium content, and the ones that opted in and let us use their testimonials are what you see in our premium membership landing pages. So what we did is we kind of organized those into whatever bit of premium membership they supported. So example, if you have something here that talks about how much your product or service is, then next to it you can have something supporting that that says the value of this product is fantastic, is well worth the price, etc. And you know, we do the same thing with our tools. If we have a tools landing page, we'll want all of the tools testimonials to support and supplement the tool information on that landing page. Thirdly, we recommend using second person supportive language in order to include your user. So things like "we invite you to" and "you deserve to have this" and talk about your website, and pretty much just support and engage the user in any way that you can. You don't want to use any stuffy kind of third person copy or language, because you know this is a landing page. The purpose is to try and engage the person and entice them to click and to purchase and to convert and use your product and all that other sexy cool stuff. So I mean, if you use the corporate speak, it's going to turn off a lot of people. So saying stuff like "we" or "I," especially you know if it's Rand, "I want you to do this," because people will think, "Oh, well, this is Rand telling me to do this," and then they're maybe more likely to convert. And then one more tip we have is to limit the navigation from your page and have it pretty much limited to just the call to action. So for example, if you are talking about tools and you need to provide an example of a tool, rather than have a link to that tool, that's a way off the page, so you might lose some users that way. Recommend having a light box, thank you Mel, or some sort of overlay that pops up over it, and then they can look at the example and then close it and stay on the same page. And then later on, have pretty much the only way off the page be the link to "get instant access now," which will take you to a sign up page or the next page in the sign up process, or you know, whatever gets the ball rolling to kind of get that conversion. Because the more channels you have off your page, the more likely you are to lose some of the people that are coming in. So try to limit that as much as you can and you'll be good to go. That's about all I have for now, so thanks for joining in, and next week we may have Rand back in fine form, or we may have another Mauser to provide you with some hefty Whiteboard Friday tips. Until then, see you next week, and hope you guys had a safe and happy Halloween.
It's over, that's a wrap.
The next day, what happened? the Toma didn't teach.
Oh, this man.
I got up in front of everyone to give my little speech. Then my teeth turned into fangs and my nails into claws. And I nearly dropped the Torah when my hands turned into paws. I growled and I roared and my rabbi did as well. It was a rocking werewolf zoo at Temple Beth Emanuel.
Hey man, where'd you learn all these Jewish words?
My manager, Harvey Lemmings. Werewolf, bar mitzvah, spooky, scary. Boys becoming men, men becoming wolves.
I just don't think the idea of the song can sustain itself for that long.